In this video, I'm going to cover how to control things from your smartphone, or you can also control from switch. First, I want to show you how I put everything inside this switch box. First, you have to switch off the MCB. If you don't take safety, then high voltage AC can be dangerous. Let's go and see inside. Here I used 8-channel relay module and our beloved ESP32 microcontroller and Hi-Link 5-volt AC to DC converter. That's it. Let's see how the whole thing is working. The ESP32 and your phone must be connected to the same Wi-Fi network to control things, because we are controlling things locally. To build something like this, what components you need? You need an ESP32 dev kit version 1 module and Hi-Link AC to DC converter, one relay module, male and female headers, and port board. I got all the components for less than $10. Solder all the components according to my schematic diagram. After solder all the components, we are ready to program the ESP32. You can write your code on Arduino IDE, but hey, I'm a lazy person. So I'm going to use pre-built open source Tasmota firmware by TURNs. Let's see how to flash ESP32. Go on your browser and type Tasmota firmware. Click on download link and then select ESP32 current release. Now here you get all pre-built binaries. Now select the web installer. Here you can program the ESP32 via web user interface. Now you can select different Tasmota release here. I'm going to select Tasmota English version. Connect your ESP32 to laptop and select your correct port. Then press boot button. Now select install Tasmota release English version. Select erase device. Press next. Hit install. Press next. Now configure your Wi-Fi. Select your Wi-Fi network. Type password and press connect. Select visit device. You are on Tasmota page. Now go to the configuration menu and then select configure module. Here you can set GPI as a relay output or switch input, or you can add any sensor. It's highly customizable. Keep in mind, switch 1 controls the relay 1 output. So after configure all the GPIO according to schematic diagram, hit save button. ESP32 restart in few seconds. Now you can control all your relay via web user interface. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something new. If you face any problem, let me know in comment section below. I would be happy to help you. In the next video, I will show you how to set up Node-RED MQTT on Raspberry Pi. Until then, hit like, share and subscribe. Peace.